great pleasure to associate myself with this auspicious inauguration of TradMed 2017, graced by His Excellency the President Maithripala Sirisena and a host of both national and international experts in traditional indigenous medical practices from the region and beyond. Specially organizing this event, I must announce that this is going to be in the history, because this will be the first international exhibition and conference on alternative medicines. Actually, I had this idea of promoting these alternative medicines even in Sri Lanka and to share the knowledge of other alternative medicines in other parts of the world. So I had the opportunity when I was invited as the chief guest for the Kerala Ayurveda Conference in 2016. I was the chief guest on the first day, and Dr. Poonam, your Honorable Prime Minister, was the chief guest on the third day. Actually, when he came to open the conference on the third day, it was a very big conference, over 5,000 delegates, where Kerala, the Ayurveda is the predominantly medicine, not the Western medicine. So when he saw me, he called me and he took me to a side. Then I proposed his idea to the Honorable Prime Minister. So he was very interested and he said, "Rajita, you take the initiative, you hold it in Sri Lanka, and that the Indian government will support you financially and otherwise. Whatever you want, you tell me, I will do all what I can do from this side." So I had a lot of courage from his statement. Then I spoke to our regional director, Dr. Poonam, and I mentioned this idea to him to get the support of the WHO. She also said the same thing, and she supported us financially and all otherwise, with all of the expert knowledge, to make this a success. So thank you very much, Dr. Poonam. And not only you supported us to hold two international conferences last year, even financially. So it's big money she gave from the WHO. Not only that, I take this opportunity even thanking you to control the dengue epidemic in this year at the beginning, when we actually sat in Colombo, with all experts, when I sat in the ministry in facing this epidemic. She also summoned her experts in Delhi, sat with them and appointed two experts, and when I requested for experts from Thailand, she looked after all their expenses and appointed another two experts from Thailand. One is from the preventive sector and the other is from the curative sector. So then in a couple of days, actually all the four experts were in Sri Lanka with the help of WHO, and they granted more money for us to help this settle this epidemic. So like that, the WHO always stood with us, and Dr. Poonam helped us. Then I came to Sri Lanka. I met His Excellency the President and I discussed with him, and he actually gave all the courage to me to hold this, that he said he will look after all the expenses. When I took the first cabinet paper, actually he helped me to get it through, and I must thank the Finance Minister and the Cabinet for approving all that money. Then I needed more money. Last week I took another cabinet paper. The President, the Finance Minister, the Prime Minister and the Cabinet, they approved the second installments also. So this made a success, and I must thank all those people. and holding this event in Sri Lanka is justified by the rich indigenous traditional medical systems of our country, well entrenched with our ancient civilization, with roots running back to the times of the Sri Lankan king Ravana of Ramayana fame. There is in the history to say that the first physician king was Ravana. So the Ravana went, and he along with another expert had taken part in an international conference held in Himalayas at that time, over so many thousands of years. So that is the actual history that we have on our traditional medicine. After that, there were so many kings, King Agbo, King Buddhadasa. King Buddhadasa not only treated the human beings, but also the animals. He was a veteran size also he looked after. So these medical systems are based on the rich assortment of medicinal plants in the country. However, the process faced setbacks during the late part of the 16th century due to foreign invasions. After that, Ayurveda developed independent of the foreign influences and continues to be practiced as a traditional process, assisted by a degree of institutional education as well as through parental inheritance. Ayurveda medical care in the country now stands at around 30,000 practitioners, more than the number of Western practitioners in the health sector, registered with the Sri Lanka Ayurveda Medical Council, of which close to 40% are academically and institutionally qualified doctors. The two key institutes for Ayurveda education in the country include the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, affiliated to the University of Colombo, and the Gampa Vikramarachi Ayurveda Institute, affiliated to the University of Kerala. Meanwhile, MD courses offered by Indian universities also contribute towards building the cadre of Ayurveda practitioners in the country. It is interesting to note that traditional and indigenous medical systems are well accepted by our people and hence coexist with Western medical practices complementing each other. Hence, it is imperative that the Ministry of Health, Nutrition and Indigenous Medicine take steps for further strengthening our national health system by further integrating these proven evidence-based traditional indigenous treatment methods and also to strengthen the Ayurveda medical education system in the country. So here I think in this symposiums we will learn about Chinese medicine, the Korean medicine, the homeopathy of the Western the German origin, then the Iranian medicine, the Myanmar traditional medicine, all sort of things. And so about so many traditional medicines, so practice in other countries. So I think actually, now Your Excellency, we can remember, after the Great Revolution in China, the chairman Mao Zedong spearheaded the campaign to re-establish the Chinese medicine in their country. Because of that, now the international conferences on Chinese medicine is held not in Beijing, but in New York or Frankfurt or Paris. That is well recognized all over. Now, actually, we must appreciate the WHO stand today, because the WHO recognizes that the alternative medicine also has a cure to our health illnesses. So our only actually interest is, because the Western medicine has not answered all the healthcare illnesses, there are a lot of blank areas where whether we could fill that with other alternative medicines. It may be Chinese, it may be Ayurveda, it may be traditional, our own, it may be Korean or Iran or Myanmar, whatever it is, the people of the world, they want some cure for their illnesses, especially the cancer. So in our country, we held a symposium on some research papers. There were 108 research papers were produced through that symposium, where there were cases where there are traditional medical doctors we have who has cure, permanent cure for diabetes. And there are people, I have met patients with liver cancer, where according to Western medicine, no liver cancer patient will live for 6 months, but there are people who live for over 5.5 years, treated by our traditional medical doctors. So therefore, it is our duty to give their knowledge, to give their experience to the new generations, to do research on these things and to find actually whether there is any cure for our illnesses. So I believe that TradMed International 2017 can thus be considered a timely move to help ushering the establishment of an integrative, evidence-based traditional medical systems in Sri Lanka and in the region. I believe that this initiative would pave the way towards multidisciplinary research, bringing together academia and industry from the region and beyond in an innovative platform. The rapidly expanding demand for herbal medicine worldwide is expected to touch US$110 billion in 2018. Mindful of these global developments, Sri Lanka hopes to develop the traditional medical systems in the country to cater for this growing demand for products and services globally. I have no doubt that for all of us, TradMed International 2017 would offer much scope and many possibilities for this purpose. I am pleased to note that the event is designed to provide an arena for the industrialists, academia, researchers, healthcare practitioners, students, etc., to communicate, interact, share experiences, knowledge and technology in realizing this goal. And I wish to congratulate the organizers for the excellent arrangement for the event and opportunities offered to a wide spectrum of stakeholders. It is my pleasure to extend a warm welcome to all of us of this auspicious event, which has brought together wide-ranging expertise in the field from all over the world. I wish the event all the success and all the foreign participants a pleasant, memorable stay in Sri Lanka. Thank you.